Hello everyone, welcome back. We're gonna have a little bit of an impromptu video, but today, February 8th, 2022, modal interactions are here. So essentially what they are, they're like sort of like forms, and I'm gonna show you how you can implement them in Pycord. We'll be working on attachments later on, but first we'll work on modals. So this code is based off of the example they have in the Pycord GitHub. I've changed it a little bit and added a little bit of information for you. So essentially you can create a class, say like it's similar to like a button or a view, right? And it's not a view, it's a modal. And you can have the title here, right? And then the type of inputs. You can have up to 5 items, and you have the label, you have a placeholder, and you have a value, which is sort of like a default, like text that's already there, and then a style, like whether you want it to be like a paragraph or if you want it short. So there are really 2 main types, long and short. I'll show you both. And then if there's a callback, we can do embed your modal results and then a color. And you can add fields for the first input, and then it's the first children, and then no inline, right? And then the second input will be the first, right? Since Python starts at 0. And then we can respond with the embed. So we can trigger this with a slash command using just a regular slash command, except we're gonna call the class, and then we're gonna use CTX interaction response send modal, and then you run the bot with your token, okay? So now I'm gonna demonstrate it. If we do test, you guys typically don't see this server, but this is my testing server. And as you can see, it says a modal. So this is our, this part, right? And then we have 2 inputs, short input and long input. So this is short input, this is long input, this is what the placeholder looks like. And this is like sort of the default, right? What we said as the value. And then the style is long and this one is just default. So the default is probably short, right? And if we have inputs, we're gonna have a response. So if I say test and I do default and I submit, it's gonna respond saying your modal results, first input test, second input default. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. It'll really help out the channel. If you have any questions, feel free to join our Discord. Thanks for watching.